فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My beloved brothers and sisters, at this time of the year, the emails that come through, the questions that the people ask, are generally regarding sadness, depression. They ask those questions. And our religion of Islam observes time, situations that the Ummah are going through. Every situation that the Ummah are in, the Quran and the Sunnah has a cure and a solution for them. The NHS, for instance, they coined a term and they called it seasonal affective disorder, which basically is, it's a type of depression that the person goes through, and it comes and it goes on a seasonal pattern. When the sun is not out, the person's depression goes up and they become sadder more and more. So what does the Quran and Sunnah say about this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way He has created this universe and the way He made this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created it for Him to test and to put people through trials and tribulations. This is the Sunanullah al-Kawniyah. It's the universal signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the reason why Allah does that is ikhtibaran. Allah wants to test you subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah also wants tamhisan. Allah wants to purify you and get rid of your major and your minor sins that you have come with. And He wants to see who is sincere and truthful about their faith which they claim. ولذلك Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, He says, وَلِنَبْلُوَكُمْ, we're going to test you, Allah says. أَمَا وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ وَلِنَبْلُوَكُمْ, we test you. وَأَمَا وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, we will test you and test you and test you. بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ, some fear we will test you with. وَالْجُوعِ, we will test you with hunger and poverty. وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ, we will test you with reduction in your wealth. وَالثَّمَرَاتِ, in the crops, Allah will reduce it from you. And then Allah says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, give glad tidings to those who are patient. Give glad tidings to those who come with patience with this test that they are put through. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He also says, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ, we will test you. بِالشَّرِّ, Allah says, we will test you with harm and evil. So Allah put the shar first. وَالْخَيْرِ, Allah will test you with good. And some people only assume and think that the harm and the calamities are what tests is. But the truth of the matter is, even when you're given children and Allah gives you wealth and things are going according to how you want it, it's also a form of a test. It's also a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah says, وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ, and to us you will come back. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, أَلِفْ لَا مِيمْ, اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمُرَادِهِ, Allah knows what He means by that. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ, do the people assume, do they think, and yutraku, that they will be left, and yaqulu amanna, that they, when they say we believe, do they think they will be left for that claim? If everybody who says I'm a believer will be left, وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ, we're not going to be tested. Did you think that Allah will leave you with this statement, I'm a believer, and you won't be tested? No, that statement of yours needs to be tested. Is it true or is it not? وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. And then Allah tells us that He tested those who came before us. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet ﷺ, he said, إِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ, if Allah wants and wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala, بِعَبْدِهِ, His slave, الْخَيْرَ, if Allah wants for him good, عَجَّلَ لَهُ الْعُقُوبَةِ, Allah hastens for him عُقُوبَة, harm and calamities. Allah hastens it for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, في الدنيا, in this world. If Allah wants good for you, He hastens the pain and the agony in this world for you. And He doesn't hold you or does not bring anything to you to the day, for the day of judgment. Everything will be brought to you in this world. وَإِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِعَبْدِهِ, if Allah wants for His slave أَشَرَّ evil, أَمْسَكَ عَنْهُ, Allah withholds bringing calamities because of the بِذَنْبِهِ, the sins that He has done, حَتَّى يُوَفِّيَ, until Allah takes His soul, subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, and He will be punished based on that. Also the Prophet said, إِنَّ عِظَمِ الْجَزَاءِ, that the great reward is in accordance to, عِظَمُ الْبَلَاءِ, is in accordance to the great calamities that a person goes through. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ, verily Allah, إِذَا أَحَبَّ قَوْمًا, if Allah loves a slave or a people, if Allah loves them, إِبْتَلَاهُمْ, Allah tests them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَمَنْ رَضِيَ فَلَهُ الرِّضَى, anyone who is pleased with what Allah has brought them, then Allah will be pleased with them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ سَخِطَى, and anyone who shows discomfort and hate towards the calamity that he's been put through now, فَلَهُ السَّخْطُ, he will gain Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's anger. The greatest people who ever walked on this earth were tested. When a little calamity is brought to us, who are we? Best people, أَكْمَلُ النَّاسِ إِيمَانًا, the people who had the greatest form of iman were tested. Rather, their tests were the severest and the hardest. That's why the Prophet said, أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ بَلَاءً, the people who are tested the most are who? Al-Anbiya, the Prophets. ثم الصالحون, and then the righteous ones. ثم الأمثل فالأمثل, and those who come after and after. يبتلى الرجل, a person is tested, على حسب دينه, in accordance to his religion. The test that comes to you is in accordance to your religion. فإن كان في دينه صلبا, if this person's religion is strong and they're upright and steadfast, اشتد به بلاؤه, the test will become more, the calamities will become more, you're being tested more. And as you all know, when the gold is burnt, it shines even more. The believer, the more calamities that he endures, the more hardship he goes through, the more he shines, the more his iman comes. وَإِنْ كَانَ فِي دِينِهِ رِقَّةٌ, if his religion is light and it's not strong and he's not upright or steadfast, إِبْتُلِيَ عَلَىٰ قَدْرِ دِينِهِ, will be tested in accordance to whatever of religion he has. فَمَا يَبْرَحُ الْبَلَاءُ, pay attention, the person will be tested so much so that he will be walking on this earth, حَتَّى يَتْرُكَهُ يَمْشِي عَلَى الْأَرْضِ وَمَا عَلَيْهِ خَطِيئَةُ, all of his sins would go through the calamities that he has endured and the hardship that he has gone through. Let's take examples of prophets and how they were tested and how much calamities that they were put through. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells in the Quran, He says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ, we gave Nabi Allahi Musa the kitab, وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ بِالرُّسُلِ, and after him came messengers and prophets, وَآتَيْنَا عِيسَى مِنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ, Nabi Allahi Isa was also given clear cut evidences. You have to realize, brothers, these prophets, they came to this world to save the people from the hellfire. This is their job. They shouldn't be put through calamities by the people. Somebody who's helping you, who's trying to save you from the punishment of the hellfire, who's working towards your salvation, your prosperity in this world and the hereafter, and you are harming him. Prophets went through that. وَلِذَلِكَ Allah then says, وَأَيَّدَنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ, Nabiullahi Isa and Nabiullahi Musa, they were supported with Jibreel. أَفَكُلَّمَا جَاءَكُمْ, Allah says, every time it comes to you, رَسُولٌ, a messenger, بِمَا لَا تَهْوَ أَنفُسُكُمْ, that is not in accordance to your desires. Every prophet comes and he tells you something that goes against your desires and what you want. Istakbartum, do you become arrogant and become hard-headed? Fafariqan kadabtum, a group of those prophets, you disbelieve in them. Wafariqan taqtulun, and another group, you kill them. Walidarika, the prophets for them was never to be followed. Their job and their aim was only for them to disbelieve in them. That's the minimum. And if they want, they actually took it a step further and they got rid of that prophet. They came to the Prophet وسلم, and they said to him, Ahida, we took an oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Alla nu'mina li rasulin hatta ya'tiyana bi qurbani ta'kuluhu an-nar. We have taken a covenant with Allah, a promise with Allah, that we will never believe in a prophet unless a fire comes from the sky and it takes our spoils of war. Then the Prophet وسلم, was said to him, say to them, Qul, say to them, a prophet, Qul qad ja'atkum rusulun min qabli, messengers have come to you before me, bil bayyinati wa bil ladhi qultum. They have come with clear-cut evidences, and they also came with what you guys are claiming, what you're asking for. فَلِمَا قَتَلْتُمُهُمْ. Why did you kill them? Why did you get rid of those prophets? And then those prophets, many prophets were killed on the people's hands. These are people Allah can protect. مَعَذَلِكَ Allah was testing them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. A prophet will come the day of judgment and no one will follow him. يَأْتِي نَبِيٌ وَلَيْسَ مَعَهُ أَحَدٌ. A prophet will come and there's no one with him. Is he not right? He is right. The test is that not what he came with was wrong. What he was preaching was not wrong. The way he preached was not wrong. But it was a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told us in the Quran, Nabiullah Musa also said to his people, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِ يَا قَوْمِ. Musa, when he said to his people, لِمَ تُؤْذُونَنِي. Why are you harming me for? Why are you putting me through hardship and pain? Why? Why are you doing that to me? وَقَدْ تَعْلَمُونَ. And you all know, أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. That I am a messenger sent from Allah. You know that. Why are you choosing to harm me? إِلَيْكُمْ. فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. The same is with Nabiullah Ibrahim. What did they say? قَالُوا حَرِّقُوهُ. Burn him. وَانْصُرُوا آلِهَتَكُمْ. And give victory to your idols. Burn this man. Get rid of him. And give victory to your idols. Your idols need you today. Get rid of this man. إِن كُنْتُمْ فَاعِلِينَ. And then Allah tells us in the Quran, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمُ. Allah made the fire which they put Nabiullah Ibrahim, Khalilullah, the five chosen prophets, from one of the five chosen prophets. Nabiullah Ibrahim was thrown into the fire. But then what did Allah do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away from the fire the heat that it would give. Allah then says, وَأَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا. They plotted and they planned against Nabiullah Ibrahim. فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَخْسَرِينَ. And we made them the losers and those who were beneath his feet. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. الإمام ابن القيم, he says in his كتاب الفوائد, he says الطريق طريق تعب فيه آدم. The path is a path for which Adam exerted himself. وأناح لأجله نوح. This path of calling the people to the religion of Allah is a path that Nabiullah Adam exerted himself. And it's also a path which Nabiullah Nuh wept, he cried. وَرُومِيَ فِي النَّارِ الْخَلِيلُ. And it's the path in which Nabiullah Ibrahim was thrown into the fire. وَأَضْجَعَ لِلذَّبْحِ إِسْمَعِيلُ. And it is the path in which Nabiullah Ismail was laid on the earth to be slaughtered. وَبِيعَ يُوسُفُ. And it's this path in which Nabiullah Yusuf was sold. بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ وَلَبِثَ فِي السِّجْنِ بِضْعَ سِنِينَ. He was sold for a very small amount of money and he remained for a great portion in prison. وَنُشِرَ بِالْمِنْشَارِ زَكَرِيَا. And Zakariya was split into two. وَذُبِحَ السَّيِّدُ الْحَصُورِ يَحْيَا. And Yahya was slaughtered and killed. And Nabiullah Ayyub lost his loved ones, lost his children and his wife and all of his kids, and his health went also. وَعَالَجَ الْفَقْرَ وَأَنْوَاعَ الْأَذَى مُحَمَّدٍ. And Nabiullah Muhammad, he went through poverty and hunger and every type of pain there were. وَلِذَلِكَ when Nabiullah Muhammad came with his message and he first came out, وَرَقَةَ بْنُ نَوْفَلْ said to him, يَا لَيْتَنِي فِيهَا جَدْعًا. He said, I wish that day that you're coming out that I would be a young man. لَيْتَنِي أَكُونُ حَيًّا. If only I was alive. إِذْ يُخْرِجُكَ قَوْمُكَ. The day when your people are going to expel you from Mecca. And then the Prophet ﷺ was shocked. He looked at Waraqat ibn Nawfal and then he said to him, أَمُخْرِجِيَّهُمْ. Are they going to truly expel me from my own hometown, Mecca? Are they going to take me out? قَالَ نَعَمْ. The Prophet said, لَمْ يَأْتِ رَجُلٌ A man had never come قَطٌ بِمِثْلِ مَا جِئْتَ بِهِ No one has ever come with that which you have come with Muhammad إِلَّا عُودِ Except that he faced great hostility from the people. When you drikani, if I reach mi waraka yomuka that day which you're lit in, ansuruka, I will give you victory. Nasran mu'azzaran, I will give you victory and support, a great amount. So Nabiullah Muhammad was told this at the early stages. But walillahi alhamdu wal minna. Every test Allah puts a people through always comes good. Turida ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam min Mecca. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was kicked out of Mecca. And what did Allah bring about with that? فَأَقَامَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ دَوْلَةِ He established in the city of Medina a government that he didn't have. So when he got kicked out, Allah brought about good for him. And the world heard about his governor, his leadership, his prophets, his army. They heard about it. عليه الصلاة والسلام. سُجِنَ أحمد بن حنبل الإمام أحمد بن حنبل was in prison. وَجُلِدَ He was whipped. But that whipping went towards something. What did he go towards? فَصَارَ إِمَامُ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ He became the imam of Ahl al-Sunnah wal Jama'ah. وَوُضِعَ السَّرَخْسِي The great Maliki scholar, Sarakhsi, a Hanafi scholar, he was placed fi bi'iri. He was placed in a well. He was in prison inside a well, a big well. And all he had with him was pens and papers. What did he do? فَأَخْرَجَ عِشْرِينَ مُجَلَّدًا He brought out 20 volumes in fiqh. Ibn Athir was also housed in prison. فَصَنَّفَ He authored two great books, جَامِعُ الْأُصُولِ and الْكِتَابَ النِّهَايَةِ فِي غَرِيبِ الْحَدِيثِ Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah was in prison and he finished the Qur'an 83 times and he died on the statement of Allah إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَهَرٍ فِي مَقْعَدِ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ مَلِيكٍ مُقْتَدِرٍ Ibn al-Jawzi was kicked out of Baghdad, his own hometown and he came back and he studied and he memorized the 10 qira'at of the Qur'an. Every calamity that comes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always brings a good out of it. You might not see it today, nor tomorrow, nor the day after, but it might be one day come. Have good faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people, when it comes to the calamities that they are brought to, are three types. The first people are mahroom, a person who is being taken away from this time to benefit from it, to come with patience, is prevented from it. So what does he come with? Su'u dhanni billah. He has bad thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he starts to suspect and accuse the qadr. Why me? Why is it being done to me? That's the first type of people. The second type of people are, he's a muwaffaq. Allah has given him the ability. He responds with this calamity. He responds with patience and endurance and forbearance. That's how he responds to it. But the third is the greatest of all. The way he responds to the calamity is beyond and greater than patience. He is pleased with it. He's actually happy. He is enjoying the calamity and the pain. He has reached darajatul rida. He has reached a level of being pleased with the calamity and the praise, and he has actually become a person who shows gratitude. Every person goes through that calamities in different forms. Some people are being put through calamities through their health and their well-being and their illness. Allah takes away from them their illness. What is needed from them is sabr, to be patient, to show endurance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has hikam, wisdom behind every action that he does. Sometimes we see that wisdom. Allah shows us the wisdom and we come to know what it is. And sometimes we're never shown it. And just because we don't know the wisdom behind Allah's actions doesn't necessarily mean there's no wisdom behind it. Allah does everything with a reason. And the reason why he chose you, there's a reason behind it. Every one of us. Another person is tested through their children, their loved ones. They have children that they love. They're trying to raise their children. And they're showing so much love to their children. But Allah has tested them with their children. Their children are choosing not to listen to them. They also need to come with patience and endurance. And know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not absent. And he is not unaware of your calling and your begging at night when you're asking for Allah to guide your child. There are other people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has engraved them into debt and financial problems. That's where their pain and their struggling is in. And other people have gone through it in other forms of shape. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he turns our hardship and our pain into ease and good for us. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawmi al-kafirin اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. ربي آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.